Hi, I'm Tim Lindquist. I'm a professor in the software engineering program at Arizona State University, and this is a video that describes for you our course, SER 423. It's one of the optional courses in the focus on web and mobile. The title of the course is Mobile Computing, and it's all about writing mobile applications and the software engineering processes involved in writing mobile applications. SER 423 uses both iOS, the Apple platform, and it also uses Android, the Google platform. One of the purposes of the course is to compare those two platforms. In SER 423, it's all about mobile development, but you don't need to have one of these things, a phone. If you do have one, a smartphone, that's fine, and it doesn't matter which platform it's on because we're going to be using both of them in the class. Either an Android or an iOS, but in fact we're going to use a simulator and emulator, simulator in iOS and an emulator in on Android in order to implement apps. This course is about native apps, meaning that they're apps that use the manufacturer's suggested APIs, programming interface, and almost exclusively use those APIs rather than going off to third party or looking at a common platform that you can use to develop apps on multiple platforms. We'll talk about those common platforms as well in the course, but we spend all of our time working on the native platforms. The course covers several different things on each of the different platforms by doing a comparison. The prerequisite for the course has recently changed. It's SER 321, which is Principles of Distributed Systems or Principles of Distributed Software. And in fact, on the page that explains the context for SER 423, you'll see all of the other courses that are necessary to take in order to take SER 321. But it's necessary to have that level of sophistication in software development, several different components that we look at in mobile development require, for example, threading, asynchronous activities, the ability to spawn different threads on both of the different platforms, to react to events and to cause things to happen asynchronously. We also look at databases, although that's not in the prerequisite. We look at how one implements a database associated with an app. So I thought it might be kind of fun just to show you very briefly a couple of different apps that are examples in the class. We'll go through about 20 or 25 different examples. They are all available to you in the class website. And in fact, it'd be good to take a look. We end up reading them and spending quite a bit of time on them. But what I'm showing you now is the IDE for iOS. It's called Xcode. And I've constructed one of these examples that has about five different Swift files. We'll be using Swift for iOS, and we'll be using Java for Android. So this is a program that's written in Swift. And I want to show you its execution on the simulator. Also in the class, we talk about the build process, not only what the app developer does for building, but also what the IDE does in order to build and deploy to a device. So here's an example of a very simple list of students, has the ability to edit, to remove students. So we'll look at what's necessary in order to do that. It has the ability to add new students. And it has the ability to take a look at the information associated with a student. So this is an example that looks at lists and how to search those lists, how to navigate from one scene to another scene using those, using lists and in the search. Go back here to search. Having the ability to categorize a search so I can search based upon, in this case, the name of the student. Or I can search in terms of the courses that the student takes. So that's under the I/O section of this course when we're looking at lists and navigation between different screens. So without going any further that, let's just end with an example, right, to be fair, end with an example of Android. So here is Android Studio. We'll be using Android Studio for doing the Android examples in the class, and this one is not on searching, but it shows in Android we have the ability to do a hierarchical list. It's kind of like a two-level tree. It's called an expandable list view, which is used fairly frequently in Android applications. So let's go ahead and run this example. This is an example which shows it. So you can see when we get the emulator up and running, there it is. With Android, we have the ability to do lists that have, let's leave it at that, expandable, so it's two levels. So I have three different, at the highest level, pets, hikes, and courses. So for the courses, we don't need that anymore, turn that off. SER 321, and when you click on that list component, it goes and displays the course web page for SER 321, SER 423, the web page for it, and then also, for example, some sample hikes, rim to rim in the Grand Canyon. So here's a web page that describes rim to rim in the Grand Canyon. So the idea is that in Android, we have the ability to have expandable lists, a two-level tree. And when we expand it, we get to see the lower levels in it, or we can actually leave them all expanded. And then the ability to navigate from one scene to another scene using those and display the contents of a web page. So we'll be using Android Studio for Android. We'll be using Xcode for iOS, Java, and also Swift for iOS. So I look forward to seeing you in SER 423 in a future semester, or maybe this coming semester.